Hi children, welcome to science class. Children, what are our basic needs? Food. Second one, clothing. And third one, shelter. Food, clothing and shelter. So about food we learnt already. About clothing we are going to learn. Do you know from where we get all these clothes? How the clothes are prepared? See here, four kinds you might have watched. Plant fiber, animal fiber. Plant fiber, animal fiber. In plant fiber, there are two kinds of things are mentioned here. One is jute, another one cotton. Here in animal fiber, silk and wool. Along with these two animal fiber, we have the skin of dead animals also used as fiber. Okay, so these are fibers that we get to prepare clothes, all these things. Have you watched any time in garden? Some tiny eggs under the leaves. Have you observed? This is the time that you can watch under the leaves or under the plant's leaves. You might have seen some eggs, some green color eggs. Do you know what are they? They are caterpillar eggs. They are eggs of caterpillars. So if you observe them clearly, the eggs will change after some days like caterpillars. Okay, eggs change like caterpillars. And these caterpillars, they eat more leaves, more and more leaves, and they form cocoons. They construct or they build a house around us to protect themselves. They make a cocoon. So from that cocoon, what will come? A moth will come out. So that is silk moth. That is silk moth. Generally what we get, those are butterflies we call them. But I am telling about here silk. So this is about silk moth. These are silk moths. And these are eggs of silk moths. Okay, generally we observe about butterflies. The same process in butterflies also. Of course, butterflies don't produce any fiber. But this is about silk moths. So the same procedure here also we can observe. Let us learn more deeply about this silk. Silk fiber. Silk fibers are obtained from animal fibers. That is, silkworms spin the silk fibers. This is called silkworm. So silkworms spin the silk fibers. There are various steps involved in silk production. The whole process of obtaining silk starting from silk moth is called sericulture. What is this process called? Sericulture. The silk production involves in four stalls. Stall 1, moth to egg. Stall 1, moth to egg. And stall 2, egg to cocoon. Stall 2, egg to cocoon. Stall 3, cocoon to fiber. Cocoon to fiber. And stall 4, reeling to weaving. Reeling to weaving. So these are the four processes that a silk fiber we obtain. In the production of silk, moths are collected and those moths are kept in grill mesh boxes in separate rooms. These silk moths are also known as Bombyx mori, and some people call them chilakalu. What is that? Chilakalu or Bombyx mori. The moths lay hundreds of eggs which are very small in size, and the eggs of silk moth worms are called seeds. These are called seeds. People allow these eggs or seeds to hatch in special chambers like over mats, on beds of chopped mulberry leaves, to get small worms, egg to moth. Okay, so sometimes people buy silk moths to produce eggs in some places also. Do you know where they sell? The places at which silk moths are sold are called grinages. So it's a kind of farming. They grow all these eggs and they change them as worms, and these worms they sell. So the places at which silk moths are sold are called grainages. Cell of you, grainages. The biggest growing center is located at Horsley Hills in Chittoor district. Where is it, ma? At Horsley Hills in Chittoor district. Here, the eggs of silk moth worms are stored carefully on the strips of cloth or paper and then sold to the silk farmers. So, what the silk farmers will do? They buy these eggs and they change them as worms. Next, egg to cocoon. Second stage, second stall, egg to cocoon. Silk farmers keep the eggs or seeds, we call them as seeds, I said no, under hygienic conditions. They won't be reckless or they won't be neglected because the silkworms should be at hygienic conditions, under very hygienic conditions. So, the silk farmers, what do? You know, they keep the eggs or we call them as seeds under hygienic conditions and at a suitable temperature. At suitable temperature, other than the silkworms never grow. And after some time, these eggs hatch into larvae, which are also known as caterpillars. We call them as caterpillars, no? Or silkworms. Their name is silkworm or caterpillar. That is the stage of larva. So, the tiny and white colored silkworms or caterpillars are placed in the trays along with freshly chopped mulberry leaves. What do they eat? Mulberry leaves. And these worms eat the mulberry leaves almost continuously. During feeding, each caterpillar sheds its skin 4 times than the before. They grow bigger in size. 4 times they grow bigger than before. And after 30 to 35 days, the caterpillars stop eating and they settle at a particular place. They settle at a particular place. At this time, these worms are transferred into big sized cane frames called chandrikalu. They are shifted to canes, chandrikalu. Now a caterpillar weaves a net to hold itself by moving its mouth from side to side and produces a fiber-like substance. This substance becomes strong when it is exposed to air and heat. So this net looks like a closed sack and covers the whole body of the caterpillar. This is called cocoon or larva. This is we call as pottukayalu also. If the cocoons are left to themselves, the cocoons develop into moths and fly away. So, when the moths come out from the cocoon, the thread will be broken. So, what do the farmers will do? They won't allow these pottukayalu to grow into moths. So, farmers kill the larva inside the cocoon by a process called stifling. By putting a lot of cocoons in a steam oven for 10 to 15 minutes. And this stifling process helps to store the cocoons in a particular places. These cocoons are kept in sealed bags and sold at the cocoon markets. Majorly cocoon markets are located at Hindupur, Madanpally, Dharmavaram, Kadiri, Palamneru, Raicholi, Raichoti and Hyderabad. These are the places we can get cocoons. Next stage, cocoon to fiber. In this stage, a pile of cocoons are collected and boiled in water to kill the larva or pupa inside the cocoon. Here, the boiling water not only kills the insects inside the cocoon, but also dissolves a gummy substance that holds the cocoons. At that time, the cocoons are dried and brushed to remove the coarse outer portion, which consists of coarse filaments. Now, the silk thread is collected from the cocoons by a process called reeling the silk. Reeling is done with special machines called reelers and twisters. So the resulting silk fiber is carefully collected from the cocoon and nearly 3 to 18 of such threads are wound together to make yarn from it, which is reeled. This yarn is called raw silk and it can be dyed into various colors. So silk fibers are then spun into like threads which are woven into a variety of silk fibers. Mainly the reeling centers are located at places such as Nandikoturu, Hyderabad, Karimnagar, etc. In only a few days, a single silkworm spins a cocoon from which a silk thread up to 600 meters in length can be removed. See how the process? However, it still takes about 2500 cocoons to make half a kilogram of silk. Reeling to weaving. The processing of silk is the twisting of one or more threads of the raw silk into a strand sufficiently strong for weaving or knitting. This process is called throwing. People weave silk fiber by using silk yarn on hand looms. See, these people get the silk yarn from the reeling centers to weave a variety in saris. Pochampalli Pattu and Dharmavaram are famous. Did you hear about them? Famous types of saris produced by our state. Pochampalli Pattu is also called tie and dye or Jamdani Pattu. Dharmavaram is famous for its wide border and rich butta or dots. Marriages mostly people wear now. Pochampalli Pattu and Dharmavaram Pattu. They weave beautiful saris and dress materials as the most typical weaving material. The skillful weavers they weave. Pochampalli is also known as the Silk City of India. Banaras, Kanchipuram, Narayanpet, Kottakota, Pochampalli are all types of silk fabrics which get their names from the places where they are made. These are the places they produce. Apart from that, there are some more varieties in silks based on the moth species such as Tassa silk, Moga silk, Kosa silk, Eri silk and so on. People involved in the process suffer from skin as well as respiratory problems due to continuous handling of the silkworm and the silk fibers. Mainly four stages are involved in this process, you know, silk production. They are moth to egg. So what are the four stages involved in the silk production? Moth to egg, egg to cocoon, cocoon to fiber, finally reeling to weaving. These are the four important stages that the silk undergo to produce a silk fiber. Okay, once again read the lesson, then you can understand well. Thank you.